afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. We are here at Expo West, and we roped in one of our friends here. I mean, I haven't seen this guy in... When was the last time I saw you?
2 years.
I haven't seen this guy in 2 years, but he's here. He's at the Expo West. He's in the U.S. Mr. Mike Adams.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Mike.
Oh, by the way, at this Expo, they want you to only keep your frame within your booth.
That's good. This is good marketing for us.
Yeah. So, okay, now we're back here at Expo West.
So, Mike, I want to talk to you about a few things today. I want to talk to you about, one, what it's like to have your own amazing garden.
Okay.
Let's start with that.
It's really awesome because, you know, I work long hours running natural news. Yeah. So I get on the computer and I work for a couple of hours, and then I go out and I just wander through the garden and I eat fresh berries and I grab fresh vegetables and I just start chewing on all the foods out there.
Right.
Or I'm gathering things up to make juice. So I make a juice and then I go back to work for a few more hours. And I just do this back and forth. So I actually, there I found this balance of having your own food and being able to also make a living and pursue your passions doing, you know, indoor things on the computer.
How big is your garden? Well, tell people you're in Ecuador, so people don't know that.
Yeah, I'm in Ecuador.
But how big is your garden, and what are some of the challenges that you faced putting it together?
Well, the garden is maybe 50 feet in diameter, and it's a circle. We built a pattern in honor of the Inca symbolism, which is also a sun-centric symbolism. So it's kind of a labyrinth pattern. And there really weren't many challenges. We basically threw some seeds on the ground and waited. We had to provide some water during the summer. It was a little dry. But the soil was so rich and so full of minerals. And we were able to grow things every day for juicing. So we can have celery every day of the year, berries every day, carrots every day. We grow cucumbers. And it's all year long. So we don't even have to think about seasons for those things. We just juice every day, whatever we want.
Right.
I mean, it's crazy.
It's so cool. And now, why Ecuador? I got to know. Because, I mean, you know, a lot of people talking about leaving the country. Why Ecuador?
Well, that was the reason, really, was to grow our own food and to have a climate. I mean, you could do it in Hawaii if you have a lot of money. Land is so expensive and labor is so expensive. South America is a good choice for many reasons. But I got to tell you, it's not a retirement resort. It's not a place for people who just want to lay back and retire. It's a culture where you need to be active and you need to learn Spanish. If you don't learn Spanish, you're not going to do well there, in my opinion.
Right.
I mean, I think the same holds true for Central and South America and Mexico as well. I know a lot of people in Mexico now.
Right.
And if you don't speak Spanish, you're going to have some challenges, big challenges, maybe even some problems. So Spanish first. Learn the language if you want to live there.
Right, right. Now, tell me about some of the new things that are coming up in the health world right now. Like, what are some of the challenges that we're facing as natural health leaders?
Oh, wow. Well, I think there's, you know, the healthcare reform discussion is big now, and there's finally starting to be some attention focused on, you know, how can we save money by improving our health?
Okay.
I mean, I talked to an insurance company that's starting to cover natural health insurance, and they want to be part of this national discussion, you know, to like, how can we save trillions of dollars over 10 years in healthcare costs by preemptively creating health.
Right.
You know, instead of.
Yeah. Do you think that the healthcare reform will include something like that?
I don't think it'll make it in. I think healthcare reform is a big sham.
Right.
It's all going to be about pumping up big pharma and the big corporations who have influence in Washington, and it's not going to be about natural health. I mean, we could revolutionize health in this country with, you know, stuff like you're super delicious. Right here, Kev's super delicious. I mean, superfoods really can save us, in my opinion, from degenerative disease. Just vitamin D. You know, sunlight and vitamin D could save us billions of dollars in cancer treatments, give us more life extension, which means more people are more productive and they're paying more tax into the tax base, so we have a better economy, we have more funding, you know, so on and so forth. But I don't see natural health taking over Washington anytime soon. Those people are all on drugs. They're on medications, Kev. Those people are all psyched out with their psychotropic drugs, and they're not thinking about natural health.
Well, let me ask you this. I know you've been covering some of the celebrity deaths that happen, you know, almost monthly due to pharmaceutical drugs.
Man, I don't know, Kev. People are dying every day.
I know.
From pharmaceutical painkiller overdoses hitting the celebrities, especially.
Yeah.
They lead very stressful lives. Making a movie is not an easy thing. It's very stressful. And so they're depending on drugs to go to sleep, drugs to wake up, drugs to have energy during the day. And, you know, they're dying from some of these drugs. Well, people have to realize there's a better way. And they haven't woken up to that yet.
Right.
But it's happening. More and more people are waking up. It just hasn't hit the mainstream consciousness yet. And I don't know when that's going to happen. I think it's going to get worse before it gets better. But long term, I think it will get better.
Yeah.
I'm an optimist long term.
You know, it's funny. You write your articles, and a lot of it's all negative, and then at the end you say optimist. I mean, really an optimist?
I'm an optimist / realist.
Okay.
In other words, I'm going to acknowledge what I see as the challenges or the problems that exist today.
Right.
But I also have faith in humanity, and I have faith in nature and our innate healing ability.
Yeah.
I think that our civilization will move forward, but we're going to have to learn some tough lessons before we take those progressive steps in the right direction.
Yeah.
You know.
Do you think that we need to stockpile grains and legumes and things like that?
Unless you're into fasting, you know.
Okay.
Long-term fasting.
So yes, all right.
Yeah, I think there will be disruptions in the food supply.
Right.
I think they'll be relatively short-term.
Okay.
Maybe a month, a couple of months. I'm not talking about total wipeout of all food. That's not going to happen.
Right.
But I think there will be disruptions from lots of different causes. And I'm just a guy who likes to teach preparedness, and I practice preparedness myself. And part of the reason I grow so much of my own food is so that I have a living food base.
Yeah.
So I'm not storing it. I'm just growing it on an ongoing basis. And you don't have to be freaked out about it. It's not about, be afraid all the time. No. It's just about being smart and being prepared and then being in a situation where you can afford to be optimistic because you know that you're covered.
Right.
That's all.
Great. Where can someone find out more information?
Naturalnews.com. That's where we have all these articles, daily articles, mm-hmm. podcasts, videos, cartoons, everything to keep you informed and entertained about natural health.
And you're going to be in Long Beach too, right? Tell us about that.
I've got an event coming up in 1 week. When is this? When are you going to run this?
This week.
This week, okay.
Yeah.
Then this weekend, this coming weekend, an event, a live event. Actually, that one's sold out, but I'm going to be at the Health Freedom Expo
right.
the following weekend, March 26th, I believe.
Yep,
26th,
yeah.
And I'll be a keynote speaker there, and yeah. It should be a very fun event. I think there are tickets still available for that one.
Friday's free, and then for the weekend it's $35.
Yeah, $35. Man, where else can you get,
Jeffrey Smith, who else is there? Kevin Trudeau?
Yeah, Trudeau's there.
Yeah, so awesome.
Unless he gets arrested again before then, or I do, or who knows who's going to show up. But we're all planning to be there.
Right.
All right, guys. I want to thank Mike for being a part of the show. Mike,
we always have a question of the day before, for our readers. What do you think we can ask them today?
Oh, how can you make your family safer and healthier in the next 5 years by taking action today?
What
can you do right now that will make that difference?
All right. This is Kevin Gianni, and with Mike Adams here, together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.